What kind of bubble bursts like this? Nothing to buy. Stay tuned to find out exactly what I mean. Promise you, it'll be worth it. Good day, Toronto. Welcome to another episode of Prime Property TV. So glad you're joining me today. The numbers for July are finally in, a little bit late, but you know, better than ever. And let's break it down. As a preface to the numbers, you should note that the summer months tend to be one of the slowest months of the year because everybody is on vacation and getting ready for the fall before the school year starts, whether it's university or high school or public school. And this is probably more exacerbated because of the pandemic and everything else is happening. Now, activities, listings, sales, basically everything falls off a cliff except for the rental market, which is exactly what we're seeing right now. So here are the numbers TRREB is reporting and the ones you'll be seeing in the media headlines. Sales are at like 9,300, down 15% from last year. Prices are at like $1.05 million, give or take. So 1.05 million, up like 13% from last year. Again, these numbers are all basically useless. So blah, 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 blah. It means nothing because last year was the only year where prices actually and sales actually increased last year because of the pandemic. So let's scrap all of those, right? So, but we gotta look at the trends of what's happening right now on a month-to-month basis. So this would technically be the fourth month in a row where sales have come down since the peak in 2020 in March, and that price is around like 1.1 peaking in May, but none of that matters despite what the headlines say. And here is why, right here. Because the months of inventory is at a silly, ridiculous 15-year low of 1 month. 1 month. There's nothing to buy right now. So when you have nothing to buy, you can expect sales to come down, obviously, right? So as for prices, they're obviously going to fall in the summer anyways. And as for this like sold to list ratio that people talk about to determine the like ferocity of multiple offers, it also comes down because less buyers, less sellers. So therefore less competition, but stuff still sells, right? So here are the numbers on a month-to-month basis. Sales are down like 20% from last month, which is a lot. And also prices are down like 2.5% from last month. Again, also a lot. And it sounds pretty bad, right? But none of this matters because it is the norm and you can expect this for next month in August as well when the numbers come out in September, right? And let me show you why in a sec. But if this is the type of real estate content you enjoy, make sure you help us spread the knowledge by smashing that like button and subscribing to the Prime Property channel and sharing this video. Now, every week we talk about real estate content that matters the most to you because all of this real talk is because we want to be transparent and honest about what the heck is happening in the real estate market because there's so much crap that is written everywhere right now. Seriously, there's a lot. And by doing this, we hope that whenever you're ready to make your next real estate move, whether it's buy, sell, assign, pre-con, or basically invest, which is what we do a lot of, you'll think, be like, oh, is that guy? He knows what he's talking about. And you'll schedule a call with us to strategize the future. That's why we're doing all of this, right? So here are my handy dandy charts on the summer months activity in the last like 10 or 13 years, something like that. So go look here, right? Now I format it for you so it's easier to parse through the data and I've blocked off each of like a black thick box in Excel. Now I want you to look at the months of inventory for this last month. It is the lowest ever in the summer months, ever. Next, I want you to look at the active listings. It's the only number in the entire column where it has four digits in it, meaning it's only summer months in the last 13 or 10 years, whatever I put, that has less than 10,000 listings. Do you see what I mean? There is nothing to buy, even if you wanted to. I have clients that are looking for stuff out there, but there's nothing good out there to buy right now, and that's the problem. So for those of you who are taking in this media narrative of, ooh, the real estate market is about to burst, the bubble and all that stuff, think about how can you have it burst when the prices are slowing down because of summer, but there's nothing to buy, but there's still demand. People are waiting for stuff to buy, right? It makes no sense. This is why I talked about last week, the ultimate metric. So you can check it out by clicking the eye up here, I think. Yeah, up here. Now, if you look at the prices for the month of September, I've also highlighted this in the chart over here for you in yellow. Look at the month-to-month increase every single year from August to September. Every single year. Do you see a pattern? It always increases, 100%. The only time summer months actually kept increasing month over month was last year because pandemic messed up the seasonality of things, right? So if you're looking for a place, whatever it is, September tends to be the time where a lot more inventory increases. But the general media isn't reporting on prices that are coming up because again, they're gonna be like, oh, it's a bubble. But that stuff comes in October, a month after the stats come out, right? And it happens basically every single year without doubt, okay? guaranteed. Now, I'm gonna pivot a little bit to change the topic so I can give you a summary of the other micro markets without turning this to a super long form podcast, because I've been known to ramble a little bit, right? So here's a summary of what's happening in the micro markets. All the 4 and 6 freeholds are basically dropping in price month to month, which is basically what I was saying earlier in this video. And that's absolutely normal because there's nothing to buy, so there's less demand as well, right? Or it's forced to be less demand. Inventory is also dropping significantly, so totally normal. Now, as for the 4 and 6 condos, listings are kind of about the same. The weird thing is sales are actually dropping, and that's kind of weird because condos aren't as seasonal as like actual freehold properties. So I'll report more on this next month when the numbers change. But this is the first month where the trends are gearing to a different direction. But like, it's not like a huge veer off. Like, prices are about the same anyways. Like, we broke the record of 722,000 sometime in the peak of this year. I think it was like in May. But ever since then, we've been like hovering a little bit below that. So, you know, same more or less. It's just a minor tweak off in terms of activity. Now, as for the 905 detaches, the months of summer should be 100% slowing down, just like the 4 and 6, because it's very seasonal. But strangely, it's not. We're at sub 1 month of inventory, like 0.88, I think, which is insanely low. The other crazy metric is that prices are still increasing in the summer months. So this is kind of behaving like a hot non-summer market right now, which is what I expect to see in the fall, like September and October. So kind of weird. Again, I'll keep an eye on it. Your average 905 detach is like 1.35 million, which is kind of insane if you really think about it. And then we're seeing the same trend for semis and towns in the 905 area as well. So if you haven't gone to my newsletter, explain more of that later. As for a 905 condo, not much. Same, normal trends, summer slowdown. That's it. Now, that's kind of a wrap for the numbers on this month. Remember, these numbers are always reported 1 month late, as in these numbers are for July right now, despite it being in like August, mid-August right now, because the numbers came out late. So when you start hearing me talk on my newsletter, and again, you can subscribe down here, and my videos during next month, activity is picking up. It's because I'm trading day to day, and you can see, and I can see the difference, but you won't be able to see that from like a bird's eye macros perspective until October, when the numbers for September come out. However, if activity is picking up like it normally does and prices do go up and you wait until you see the macro October perspective before you do something in the market, you're gonna be behind. And my suspicion is that for the latter half of the year, prices will go up a little bit more, kind of is gonna be where the new norm is, and we'll be hovering around the peak prices of what we saw around like 1.1 million. As for sales, they obviously tend to increase as well, assuming there's more inventory. Hopefully we're, you know, over 1 month, hopefully, because I would prefer that. But ultimately, like, we're still gonna be in a seller's market for the rest of the year, unless we're seeing a ton of inventory flood the market, which I don't think so. So normal Toronto, you know, Toronto kind of style market, seller's market, low inventory, you know, prices are slowly going up, which is kind of what we're accustomed to, right? So if you're looking for a strategy for the coming market, depending on what you're trying to do, you can book a call with me using the link right here. I'll be available for another week or so before I take off for a long way to vacation before the craziness, which I'm expecting in September. So for now, we finally got the numbers for July, and I suspect it'll be the exact same thing for August when the numbers come out. So, you know, same, don't worry too much about it. Until next time, your move, your future. See ya. Now that you're done watching this one, how about this one? Oh, you know what? This one's good too. Ooh, this one's really good. You know what? Just watch them both.